할렐루야. 디 그레드. 빌리 조이스. Now, with me. Together. They enjoyed the word of God with the preaching. Today, I'm continually preaching under the title, Are You Preparing for Jesus' Return? Part 2. Last week, I had preached in the part 1. Now, you can see what I'm telling you, that it's we have to focus on our life and the central of Jesus Christ while we remain in Jesus Christ in this life before Jesus Christ coming. When Jesus returns to take his people, you and me, to heaven, our home, we must be ready, spiritual preparation cannot be bought and borrowed at the last minute. Yeah. Here is a scripture, what Jesus told as a parable of ending time. Matthew 25, chapter 10 through the 13. You know, the 10 virgins, the parable of 10 virgins, who 5 were prepared the oil, which is the Holy Spirit, to meet Jesus Christ, our bridegroom. But the other 5, the virgin who did not prepare the oil in lamp, so they couldn't meet bridegroom. They are waiting because Bible says door is shut. They say, oh Lord, Lord, open the door. What Jesus said? I don't know. Too late. I don't know. Oh, sir, so open the door. I want to see you. Jesus said, of conclusion in this parable, therefore keep watching, because you do not know the day of the hour Jesus will come. And the same chapter 25, as you know, the parable of talent. Everybody knows. And the same chapter, parable of the separation of sheep and goat, that he going to judge the goat. Bible say goat representative of unbelievers will face eternal punishment. Sin, oh my Lord, we receive the eternal life. Oh, hallelujah. Here are three steps you can take to stay focused on God's future. When Jesus Christ will come in your daily life and will be engaged in your life now. Firstly, anticipation. When Jesus was 8 days old, his parents took him to the temple in Jerusalem to be circumcised according to Jewish law. There, they encountered an old man who was eagerly anticipating the coming of the Messiah. His name was Simon. Do you know him? God, listen, my brothers and sisters. Simon, God revealed him that he would see Messiah before he died. Later, Joseph and Mary brought Jesus to the temple. Simon knew that God had kept his promise. He realized that God had kept promise that Simon was waiting for to greet to his Messiah. Here is the evidence what Simon did. We see Simon walked up and took the infant Jesus in his arms and prayed to God, saying, Oh Lord, now you are letting your servant depart in peace according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people. A light to bring the revelation to the Gentile. We are Gentile. And the glory of your people Israel. Luke 2 chapter 25:32. Here is a point I want to tell you. And I have read and Simon's story. Listen carefully. Simon is a good example of the mess someone who anticipated the first coming of the Messiah. You and I live in wondrous time now. We are really living in last times. We live in between the great salvation event. The great salvation event. What that mean? The first coming of Jesus, the Christ, as our Redeemer for humanity, for all human beings. And his second coming to set up God's kingdom in this earth. Hallelujah. Oh, praise the Lord. Give him glory. Jesus came as a Redeemer in first coming. Jesus came as a Lamb of God, which is to be died on the cross for your sins and my sins. Jesus Christ came in the manger, which is very low placed, to save all mankind. But, here is a good voice. I want to speak to you right now. Second coming, we are eagerly waiting for. Like Simon, who was waiting for the Messiah. Jesus Christ will come as a King of Kings, of Lord of Lords. He will come as a conqueror that he ruled all this world in second coming. He will come the root of the David and the morning star in second coming. He will come the victorious our God in glory that is going to set up his kingdom in this earth. Hallelujah. Pray to give him glory. Oh my Lord. Oh, come on, somebody help me. Help me, come on, somebody. Oh, my Lord, my God. Oh, thank you, Lord, give me glory. Oh, I'm brought out by the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord, give me glory. Oh, I want you to understand. Our time in history needs to be central to our daily life. He will come in second coming to destroy the evil and injustice, unrighteousness of man in this world, to eradicate the poverty and the violence in second coming. We should remember that time is coming of his return. you can only maintain that anticipation for coming of Jesus Christ. Now, properly through your prayer and the Bible study. Yes. Anticipation. Yes. Anticipation is flamed by daily communication with God. I'm talking about your prayer. We make a relationship with God by prayer. That is going to anticipation of second coming. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Lord. All right. Second, I want to tell you. Preparation. Second coming is far more than just you think that this is a nice idea of you may thought fantastic future of Jesus Christ coming. Much, there will be much more than that you imagine. Second coming, hallelujah. You must be spiritually preparation for that event. What we have to learn from the Bible, we must become an integral part of our daily life. You know, Jesus repeatedly said he would leave this world and he would return at some future time, second coming. Christ return at unexpected time, nobody knows, only God knows it, second coming. It's not a trap, it's not a trick by which God hopes to catch as off guard. No, he's not going to play with you of the second coming. His second coming of Jesus Christ is real. That is coming soon now. It's like first coming. It is real. We see. He also said that the kingdom was being prepared for their followers, Christian. We must be prepared. Everything we gotta do before he's returning, second coming. In fact, I wanna tell you more. God is not, you know, God is not delaying his returns. Then we see, we are looking forward to his coming. And God is delaying, we thought, is too long to wait. Listen, my brother and sister. God wants people to save more. That God is waiting. God with patience, the people get saved. 2 Peter 3:9. Oh, my Lord. Many people will believe his return, but will not be prepared for this thing. Yeah, that's true. Many people, Christians know Jesus Christ will come, but they don't prepare, which they got to do for the prepare to greet Jesus Christ as Jesus Christ command, be watching, be alert before I will come to you. Many books in Old and New Testament, Jesus Christ had warned of his second coming to his people, disciples. But this time, same thing. Many people did not prepare for his return coming. Even they know that he will come. That is a big problem now. We see. It is time to wake up. It's time to watch. Be prepared. It's time for major spiritual lifestyle change. Oh, thirdly, declaration. What is the declaration? What I'm going to tell you about declaration. I'm not saying that you should go door to door and try convert your neighbor as like Jehovah Witness. You know what I'm talking about. they used to visit the every house and every area. Yeah, you know. What I'm saying, if you are truly anticipating, I've told you, and preparing, which you gotta do for the prepare in second coming. For the Christ to return, you will do in your action, you will do by your action, your activity, which you gotta do. You gotta do which you gotta do for the Jesus Christ before his return. And declare the gospel in very action that you are are a citizen of the coming kingdom. That is a declaration we gotta do for the kingdom of God. You cannot hide your light under the bushel. You must, through our Christian example, our life, faithful life, sincere life, through the our living lifestyle, we have to declare Christ's return until he stands on the mountain of Olives. Bible say, his feet will be stand on the Mount of Olives. Yes, I believe. We see through the TV. We have to be developing the character of Christ. We have to be doing those things that he did. We need to look at ourselves. We have to say ourselves, where am I now? Am I really preparing to be there? We need a question for ourselves every day. We declare that we believe in the return of Jesus Christ by our example and our life, that we have to live in Jesus Christ. We'll let you know the other people that we are ambassador of Jesus Christ. We are the children of the God who will show them that we are citizens of God. That is evangelization of the world. Everybody follow us, everybody, and believing in Jesus Christ finally. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. How do you live your life? What is your mindset? How do you treat other people? We have to think about that. Are you exhibiting the fruit of the Spirit recorded in Galatians 5, chapter 22, 23? Can you bear the fruit of the Holy Spirit in your life? Love, joy, peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, self-control. We have to bear this fruit of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. When we do that, the rest of our life will take care of itself. Yes, God take care of you. If we do God's work, God gonna work to you. We'll be prepared to meet Jesus Christ at his return. Hallelujah, pray the Lord. People, I want to make conclusion. People who are ready for their Lord's return, first I want to say, not hypocritical, but we have to be sincere, not be fearful, but ready to witness of Jesus Christ. You are witness, I am witness to Jesus Christ. Not worry about that, but trusting in the Lord. Trusting in the Lord, hallelujah, pray there. Your reward is great, hallelujah. Not greedy, but generous to other people. God will love you. God will want to bless you. Not lazy. Lazy, demon going to give you lazy. But be diligent. Diligent, must be diligent. Hallelujah. Oh, may your life be more like Christ. Be like Jesus Christ, Paul said. Imitate Jesus Christ day by day. So that when he comes, yeah, I believe he comes soon. Many, many signs we see in every day now. I want to tell you one more time. Great sign appeared these days. North Korea, which is, I can't believe, has threatened America and other nation by nuclear weapon. You have to think about this nuclear weapon. Jesus Christ said, prophesied this matter, nuclear weapon in the last days. I believe, before I have told the last sermon, but most in the prominent sign of the last day that Jesus Christ prophesied in Mount Olive prophecy was nuclear weapon. Now we see by the some country, North Korea, like Iran. Yes. In all the revelation, it indicates that last days, what happened? Before Armageddon, nuclear weapon, like an ICBM, enemy going to use. But Jesus said, for the sake of the elect people, time will be short. Yes, you can see. All right, you and me will be ready to greet our Lord Jesus Christ joyfully. gradually that we are waiting for, like Simon, who was waiting for the first coming. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. Bye-bye, see you later.